Hello students, today we will discuss the poem The Long Way Home. When I go back home from Billy's place, I always have to roam the mazy road, the crazy road that leads the long way home. Ma always says, "Why don't you come through Mr. Jonkin's land? The footbridge track will bring you back." Ma doesn't understand. Children, this poem is about a boy who loves to have adventure while coming back home from his friend Billy's house. He says that he has to cross the crazy road, the mazy road. Now here, the crazy and mazy road means that the road is quite long and there are so many twists and turns that he has to give more time, and that only makes him to reach home late. Actually, the distance from his friend's house is not so long, but because he loves adventure, so he likes to roam around and see the things that come across on his way home. So what he does, he takes the longest route. Now his mother keeps telling him, as in the third line you can see, Ma always says, "Why don't you come through Mr. Jonkin's land? The footbridge track will bring you back." Ma doesn't understand. Now his mother keeps telling him, "Why don't you take Mr. Jonkin's land way? Come from his farm, there is a footbridge. Take that and come home on time." After that, the lines are, "I cannot go that way, you know, because of Jonkin's dog. So I set forth and travel north and cross the fallen log. Last week when I was coming by, that log had lizards in it. And you can't say I stopped to play if I just search for a minute." But the boy has his own excuses for that. He says that he's scared of Mr. Donkin's dog. He doesn't like that dog and he's quite scared of that. But his mother is unaware of the fact, so he's saying, "I cannot go that way, you know, because of Donkin's dog. So I set forth." Forth means to move forward, to move ahead. So he takes another route, and that other way is towards the north, where he has to cross a log. A log is a huge piece of wood, as you can see in the picture. And the log has got many holes in it. So the lizards have made their homes in that. And when he comes across that log, when he tries to cross that very log, he saw the lizards over there. And that also fascinates him. So what he does? He sits there for some time. He spares some of his time and see the lizards playing in and out of that log. After that, the lines are, "I look around upon the ground. And if there are no lizards, I go right on and reach the turn in front of Mrs. Blizzard's. I do not seek to cross the creek because it's deep and floody. And Ma would be annoyed with me if I came home all muddy." Now again he gives this excuse to his mother that if I'm not getting the log or if I'm not seeing the lizards in that log, then I go to some other place. So what he does, he takes the route from Mrs. Blizzard's place. Now Mrs. Blizzard's place is quite far from him. So he has to roam a lot and take a long way to reach home. He can try some other way also. There is a creek. Creek is a small stream full of mud. And seek means attempt to find something. And he says if he tries to cross the creek, what will happen? His mother would get angry. His mother would get annoyed. Why? Because if he tries to cross the very creek, his clothes will get dirty or soiled. So his mother would get angry. That is why he just makes all these excuses and comes home late. So this is basically a poem of coming home. Actually, the distance is not so long, but the poet C.J. Dennis has described that why he is becoming late. Why? Because he is roaming here and there. So the way he is coming by, he has described only that way in the poem. So go through the poem, read it once. I hope you can understand now clearly. Thank you.